Okay, so guys, so how many of you here are aware of what is Tableau? Any idea? Any idea here? Anyone? Any idea here? Anyone?
Basic visualization tool. Through that we can, it's like Excel you can say, or where we can make visualizations, charts. It's little bit high, advanced than that we can say. And yeah, that's what.
Okay, anyone
Thank
else guys wants to throw some light here? Anybody? Okay, no worry, no worry. So we will start the session from the scratch, guys, because I see that many of us don't understand to all about. So I will start from this scratch, okay? So basically, when I'm talking about the Tableau, okay, before we even get into this, I want to again go back to our workshop. Okay, if you remember, on day one of a workshop, we did learn about the variations in the role of business analysis. Okay, so if you remember, what is the definition of a business analyst? It says that business analyst is a multitasker, if you remember. Okay, when I meant multitasker, guys, what does that multitasker mean? We, as a business analyst, we might have to get into the shoes of multiple roles in a project. Okay, having said that, we also will work on multiple variations as a business analyst, right? We would be called as an IT BA. We would be called as an Agile BA. We would be called as an BPM BA. Okay, we would be called as a BIBA. We would be called as a business architect. Okay, we would be called as a system architect, system manager, requirements engineer, and so on and so forth, guys. Okay, so what I'm trying to tell you is, see, as a business analyst, our main goal is to make sure we work in a project and make sure we deliver the project. Okay, at the same time, we should also make sure the organization is also benefited. Don't you agree? When you're only trying to work for the client and the client would leave, and who is going to talk to you later on? The client leaves the organization. So, as a business analyst, we should always create a balance between the client and the organization. Okay, right? On similar note, guys, so what do you mean by this report? Okay, today I would want to talk more on the business intelligence business analyst. Okay, so now today's topic on Tableau concentrates more on this BIBA. Okay, now what do you mean by BI to begin with? BI is called as your business intelligence. Okay, now what do you mean by business intelligence? When I'm talking about this business intelligence, how intelligently or probably how smartly you're able to pull out the decisions from the business is called as business intelligence. Basically, it is nothing but the technical intelligence, guys, that you would require. Okay, the business intelligence concentrates more on the collection, okay, collecting, probably analyzing. And most importantly, storing. What will I do, guys? What is collecting, analyzing, storing, stores? What will I do? So here, please understand, business intelligence concentrates analyzing and the storage of the data. Okay, please remember, one of the very critical decisions that a client or a company would take will completely depend on the data. Okay, guys, now I will want to give you a very small scenario here, guys. I would want to take an example of Tesla. Anyone who knows, who does not know what is Tesla, please unmute and tell me, guys. I can explain that. What do you mean by Tesla? Anyone? Who is Tesla?
No, I don't know.
Okay. So guys, basically, Tesla is a car company.
Test, yeah.
Remember, CEO of Tesla?
Sorry?
Who is the CEO of a Tesla, guys?
Elon Musk.
Very good. Are you
Elon
famous?
Musk. because of this so innovative ideas about the cars and
nothing. No, simple. Elon Musk is known only for being the wealthiest man in the world. The wealthiest man in the world, guys. So he has more money than anybody else can think about. You know, he has in billions. So yes, Elon Musk actually came into. For being the wealthiest man in the world, and the wealthiest man in the world, he has innovative ideas as well. Okay, if you really talk about Tesla, Tesla is known for what?
Cars.
Environmental friendly motors. Okay, Tesla is the one who actually introduced the idea of electric cars. And the reason why it's so expensive. They are the one who introduced electric cars and trying to work towards it. So having said that, guys, I don't want to deviate from here. So basically, Tesla, if you talk about these very big organizations who actually concentrate on these extremely expensive investments and models and cars, they concentrate more on the data, guys. That is what I'm trying to tell you, okay? So basically, any kind of decision that this organization would want to take, like for example, do I have to create a new model? Should I introduce the model? Which year should I introduce? What kind of categories should I really concentrate on? All these kind of decisions are only taken with the help of data. Okay, so as a business analyst, your only job is not to advise people, but also help the organization. Should I take the project or not? Okay, who will give the decision? What basis will you make the decision, guys? On what basis should we make the decision? Any idea?
The data only.
Only based on the previous data. And if you talk about your organizations also, don't you think you kind of take decisions based on your previous quarterly data? Yes. We do that, right? So what I'm trying to tell you here is, please understand that data analyzing is a very, very, very important topic. And at the same time, very recent topic. If you're talking about data analysts, data analyst is also a business analyst. He is the one who will concentrate more on the data. Okay, so the business intelligence concentrates more on the data collection, analyzing and storage. Clear so far, guys? Any questions?
No.
Good. Okay, so now moving forward. Now we have multiple business intelligence tools available in the market. What are the very recent tools from SAP? We have from Oracle. We have from Zoho. We have Power BI. Okay. We have Tableau also. Okay. So among all these tools, please understand again the reason why we are not getting very, 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 very deep inside any tool, because we cannot guarantee if your organization that you will going to join will use Tableau or Power BI. We don't know. But for the interview sake and for you to really understand what happens inside the tool, we should get a basic understanding. Clear so far, guys? So today we will concentrate more on the Tableau. Okay, clear? So now, Tableau. Why should we learn Tableau? Any idea, guys? Why Tableau? Why not?
Why Tableau? Converting data into the visualization, which can be easily understandable.
Yes. So basically, for
big data.
Yeah. Go ahead. What? Sorry.
To be big data, basically, that is what you are talking about, right?
Big data.
Tableau.
No.
Yeah.
My question is why Tableau? Basically, why am I saying why Tableau is because Tableau is nothing but, as someone told me, it is a very strong and a very good data visualization tool. Now, what do you mean by data visualization? Guys, it's a very simple term. Data visualization is converting your data into the pictorial format. That's it. Please remember, it's no big deal, guys. Converting your data, your numbers, columns and rows into some kind of pictorial representation of your information. What is pictorial representation, guys?
A chart, bar graph, chart,
yeah.
Different graphs.
Exactly. Yeah, it's only trying to convert your rows and columns into graphs, charts, your tables, your maps, or however you want. It is trying to convert it into that pictorial Express presentation. Okay. So that converting that data is called as data visualization. How, what am I doing? I'm visualizing the data in a more beautiful manner. That is called as data visualization. And Tableau and all the BI tools that is available just now would concentrate on data visualization. So a Tableau would actually convert the raw data into a very easily and a very understanding format. Please understand, if somebody asks what is Tableau, Tableau is a data visualization tool that would convert the raw data into a very user-friendly, easy and an understandable format. Remember this. Clear so far, guys? Okay. That kind of conversion is called as Tableau, and the reason why people would use Tableau, okay, is for that. So what are the very important features of Tableau, guys? That is nothing but you are trying to blend the data into multiple formats. You're trying to understand the real-time analysis through Tableau. And you're also trying to collaborate data of different scenarios. See, I'll give you a real scenario, you'll understand. But here we're trying to data blend, collaborate the data, trying to create a real-time analysis and give a real information about what is Tableau. Are we clear so far, guys? Okay. Now, so now let's talk about what we have in Tableau.
Hello, madam.
Yeah, please. Yes.
Hello.
Yeah, hello.
Madam. Madam, once you scroll down the screen, tools, madam, BI tools.
Oh, okay.
Are these tools, all these are same, madam, SAP, Oracle, Zoho, Power BI, and Tableau?
If you really ask me, there are like, you know, if they are very similar, what I'm telling you. The reason being, you know, either if it is SAP, Zoho, Oracle or anything, they're very similar. They're, if you go inside, no, they're very similar. The fields, the kind of navigation that you go, it's very similar. And if you learn one tool, guys, one tool, it'll be very easy to navigate through other tools. And also, don't worry, the organization will give you the training. Did I answer your question?
Okay,
ma'am. I did answer, right?
Tableau and Power BI are almost same, but different remaining are different.
No. Tableau, everything is same. Everything is same. What I'm telling you is the navigation might be a little different, but the fields are very similar. The way you data, you pull out the data, you create the charts and all that are very similar.
Okay.
Yeah. The reason why we are
called SAP is a software. Yeah, madam. SAP is a software, madam, but it's a software tool, I think.
Everything is software tools, you know. All are. Everything has to be installed. All is Tableau, Power, everything has to be installed by the client in your computers. Nothing is open source. Okay.
So in Tableau, what we do in Excel and PowerPoint, it is a combination of both.
No, honestly speaking,
the data charts and
Excel only is like 1-2% of what is Tableau. Tableau is a very interactive source. So with Excel, what happens is you can
only... Okay, so heavy files also can be stored.
I'm sorry?
Heavy files are also stored.
Undoubtedly.
Not in Excel, that much heavy files are not
stored. Exactly. Not just the storage, but also you can also create these very interactive reports. You know, if you talk about Excel, the data really can't
attractive be reports.
Lot of, background thing that you have to do in Excel. But in Tableau, one number is changed in the data, everything else is changed. So that's the best advantage. They're very user-friendly tools. These BI tools are very user-friendly.
Okay. And it is very colorful and attractive also.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
Okay.
The advantage here with Tableau and the BI tools is, guys, in Excel, you had to do the changes and all this for individual cell and individual report. I mean, it's a lot of manual work that you had to do in Excel. you have to create one report, imagine what kind of, you have to change this, you have to change that, you have to go here and there. But Tableau, it is automatic. You know, one thing you change, everything else is, you know, very interactive. We'll talk about it. Don't panic, guys. I'll explain you what I'm trying to tell you here, okay? Are we clear so far, guys? So basically, what do we have as a products? What are the products that Tableau will provide, which is called as Tableau Product Suite? Okay, under Tableau, what all products do we have? The first product is called as Tableau Desktop. Okay, so basically, Tableau Desktop is nothing but a more customized format wherein you will be creating the charts, reports, and so on and so forth. Most importantly, it is a purchased version. When you go work in organizations, you will get a purchased version. Okay, wherein you can do a lot more things on Tableau Desktop. Okay, so Tableau Desktop is mostly wherein you're trying to do analysis, data blending, all that can be done in Tableau Desktop. It is not a free version, it is a paid version. Okay, that's it. Remember this. Now, talking about your Tableau Public. Tableau Public is only for you to try and experiment and understand more about Tableau. Okay, so in Tableau Public, you can do everything, but please understand when I'm using the word public, it means everything can be seen by others and everything can be shared by other users in Tableau. Okay, so one very important thing what I'm trying to tell you is, guys, in Tableau Public, please do not use any kind of confidential data of your organizations. And right now, we will be only using Tableau Public. For learning purpose, we would use Tableau Public. Clear so far? So there is no privacy out there. Now the third product is called as Tableau Server. Okay, Tableau Server is more like a locker or a repository wherein whatever data, whatever things you're working on Tableau Desktop, you can save all that in a Tableau Server. Please understand, it is not your organization server. The Tableau themselves will give you one server where you can save your data. Okay, once your work is done, you can convert, you can transfer that to your servers. Clear so far? There's anybody here who does not know what is a server? I can explain it again because we have learned this in the workshop. Anybody who does not know what is a server, please let me know, guys. Unmute and tell me. So I'm assuming we all know what is server. What are servers? Okay. So guys, what do you mean by Tableau?
Yes, please explain once.
A service? So guys, basically, what do you mean by a server? Server is nothing but a repository, or in simple words, is called as a locker. Okay, in organizations, we have multiple servers. What servers do we have, guys? We have a development server. Okay, we have a UAT server. You have a deployment server. Okay, now what do you mean by a development server? This is a server where the developers will work on it, and once the work is done, they will move this server, they will move the data from the development server to the UAT server. Okay, so whenever the development is happening in the course of the developing phase, okay, you will put all the data, the development data, in the development server. It's a very temporary locker. Okay, so once your project is over, you will clean the development server and then a new project will be given the access to it. Okay, then you have a UAT server wherein the client will have an access and he can do the UAT testing in this server. Okay, then we have a deployment server. It is nothing but a go live server wherein, you know, the complete, almost like your 100% perfect data, errorless data will sit in the deployment server. It is more like giving the work to the client. So at the end of the project, you will give him access to the deployment server where the client will take over the completed work to his. So as I mentioned earlier, what's going to happen is a Tableau will give us a server. Okay, so whatever data that you're working on, you can use it through Tableau. Clear so far, guys? Is it clear? Whoever asked me the question, right? Is it clear now? Okay, now move into Tableau Online. What is Tableau Online? Tableau
what Online. Extension of these files, Tableau?
I'm sorry?
What extension? What are the extensions for these Tableau files?
We'll learn it. Once we get in Tableau, we'll explain it to you.
Okay.
Okay. So now we have another product in Tableau called as Tableau Online, wherein we will not going to do anything, but we'll only try to share the data. That's it. The share the reports, not the data. Tableau Online is only used for sharing. Okay. Its functionalities are very, very similar to nothing but the server, wherein in the server, I would share the data, but in online, I will share the reports. Okay. So it's a very, very small. There's no storage limit to Tableau Online. So please understand. Online is only used for sharing the reports. That's it. And the final one is called as Tableau Reader. Tableau Reader can actually read the content. Okay, it is only trying to help you view the workbooks and the visualizations and everything by created by in the public and the desktop. Okay, so if you go join organizations would take your Tableau desktop. Other things are very understandable. Okay, so for practice, we would learn Tableau public, and in the organization, they will have a Tableau desktop. Okay, clear so far, guys? Yes.
Ma'am, for students, they provide desktop for free. With the student's ID, they can provide the Tableau desktop. So, is it possible?
I didn't understand.
So, actually, in the Tableau desktop, it's a version, right? So, but for the students,
it's a paid version of Tableau.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So for the students, if they provide their ID and other details, it is free for them. So no. Is it by chance that it is there? Actually, I saw it on the website only. So it's there for the students. They are providing it.
Probably it's a paid version. So probably whoever wants to take Tableau desktop, you have to buy it from Tableau. But for understanding, I mean, we don't have to buy Tableau, because I'm again telling you, right? Tableau is not a tool which compulsory every organization would use. What if we are buying a tool and later on it is not required, there's no point, right? So for a practice, you can actually practice in Tableau public anyways, right? Once you understand how the reports are created,
we are good to go. Yeah, it's 14-day free trial actually.
Yes. Okay, guys, can I move forward?
Yes, please.
Okay, so now
The process, features or the options which we are learning in public is the same in, is that same in desktop also? Because once we join in a company,
it should be. Probably you'll have more. Public, but undoubtedly the basic navigation is very similar to what we are learning here.
Okay.
So what are the users of Tableau? Why Tableau? Why not SAP? Why not other tools? Why are we learning Tableau? Okay. Please understand very well, number one, for Tableau, there is no coding required. Okay, because as a business analyst, we do not do coding, and we only believe in functionalities or functional part of the project. I mean, we are using Tableau and we have selected Tableau because with Tableau, there is no coding required. You do not have to do coding at all. Okay, and very important, as someone said, with Tableau, you can import large amount of data, large size of data, large amount of data. You can import it to Tableau. Okay, clear so far, guys? Okay, and most importantly, you can also work on multiple reports with data. I mean, the way you can visualize, there are multiple options you can visualize the data. Data visualization reports are there, which will actually make it more creative and very, very interactive. And apart from this, definitely there is data blending is there. There is probably you can also coordinate, you can also collaborate the data. You can take different. And one more thing I like about this is about Tableau is you can actually just attach the data from your personal computer or your film computers, guys. See, if you're talking about other tools, you have to do a lot of story. They should have a certain size, they should have a certain format, blah blah blah. But with Tableau, however raw your data is, you just have to say copy and paste it. It will directly get pasted into Tableau. Okay, you can definitely take the raw data. You don't have to do any kind of changes. There is no, this many columns, these many rows, blah, blah, nothing like that. It's a very, very user-friendly tool wherein you can just pull the raw data and put it into the tab. Clear so far, guys? And very, very important thing, please understand, there is no coding requires. A very basic tool you can work on. Are we clear so far, guys? Okay, now we know that why is it better than Excel? Because with Excel, you can only work on a very, very limited data, but Tableau you can, and you can, there's a lot of ways you can create, lot of different, you can actually create, I think it is 250 applications you can interact, and you can also create multiple, I think it is around 20 or 30 ways you can really play with your data. Are we clear so far, guys? Any doubts, any questions with Tableau? Why Tableau?
Ma'am, can you just repeat that data blending and collaborate part?
Data blending is where...
Data blending and collaborate.
Yeah, yeah, sure, sure. See, what do you mean by data blending? Data blending is you're just trying to blend two different kind of data. Like, for example, let's assume you have a data in an Excel sheet. Okay. And you also have data in your... other format. So what are you doing? You're trying to blend two different sources of data, and then you can create a nice report out of it. That feature is called as data blending. You can take an Excel, you can take a PowerPoint, okay. You can take a PDF, you can take an Excel, you can combine both and you can do the blending of the data.
Okay.
That is,
and then, collaborate.
Collaboration is nothing but similar to collaborating. Collaborating is you're just taking this fields, those fields. Okay, two different Excels. You collaborate and you will create the reports.
Okay, ma'am.
Clear so far?
Fine, thank you.
I mean, we don't do all this blending and this thing, but again, it's a very important feature you should know, because we have data analysts who actually will concentrate and work more towards the data. But as a business analyst, you should know, and it's a very important interview question they might ask, why Tableau, why not other tools? You can answer that question. Clear so far, guys? Any doubt?
Collaborating
is when you're trying to collaborate two different fields. And let's assume you have an Excel sheet one and Excel sheet two. You want to take one row from here, one column from there. What will you do? You have to again create another data, no?
Yeah, merging.
So here I would not do that. I would most importantly, I would take different fields and I will collaborate, and I can, yeah, in other words, merging can also be the answer. Yeah. Good so far?
Yeah, madam. Blending means we are mixing two types of sources and creating only one source.
One reports, not
like source. Excel. Yeah, ma'am.
You're creating reports.
Like a PDF and PDF and Excel, and we are creating only one PDF or Excel.
Exactly.
Finally.
Exactly. Yes. Yeah. That's how we do. Okay, clear so far?
Yes, madam.
Okay, guys. So now let's move forward. Is it all clear so far? With what is Tableau and what, why we do Tableau and all that. Good, right? What products we have, what are the users of Tableau.
Yes.
Now, let's go talk about how do we install Tableau. Guys, in Tableau public, I'm talking about installation of Tableau public. Okay. How can we install Tableau public? Number one, you can actually let me show you it later also. No. public download.
Yes, ma'am, it is breaking. Can you just repeat it again?
Just a second.
Whatever you have said.
Let me actually use my. And one second. give your email ID, you will download the app. Okay, number one. Okay, once you have done that, it will start the downloading in a .exe file. Okay, guys. So once you see that, you will say yes, open the downloaded file, and then you will access the terms and you'll install the button, install the application. Okay, then you will get an option to start the screen, and then you will install the Tableau. Is it just for? I am unable to do it because I have already installed Tableau on my computer. Clear, guys? Do it. Okay, so now when the installation is over, then I would definitely want to get to the app. Yes. So this is how you will
visualize like it. And trying to open Tableau, guys. Guys, just a second. I'll share it again once I open Tableau, okay? One second.
just taking open Tableau. Meanwhile, if you want to install, you can do that, guys, just to save time. So that if you have any doubt, I can clear it off right away. Okay, can you all see my screen? So this is how you will be able to come to this screen. Okay, this is called as Tableau public. Here it says you can connect. So as I mentioned earlier, Tableau would allow you to connect to any kind of your data that is available in these formats. It could be Microsoft Excel, your text file, JSON file, Microsoft Access, PDF file, your spatial file, or your statistical file. Any kind of data you can actually connect using these extensions. Then, if at all you have any kind of a data sitting in a server, okay, any data that you cannot download, but you definitely want to create reports from this server, you can also do this. If you have O data and you have multiple other areas where you can go to and you can pull out the reports from. Okay. So if you want to connect to a server, but again, this will only happen if I would recommend this for a Tableau desktop version, but not for public. Please understand, whatever data you are pulling out here is viewable by all the people who are using Tableau all around the world. Okay, so my suggestion is, please do not use any kind of your organization's data. It is only for our practice. So let's use very generic data, guys. Clear so far? Okay, now see, understand here, if you want to, let's assume you did work on anything on Tableau Public and you want to view others' data. You just have to go on open from Tableau Public, click on it. Whoever has previously worked with Tableau Public, I can view their data. Okay, clear so far? So right now I would not want it, and now we can also go to this open. Before doing that, see, when you're trying to work on the Tableau, I might not have that kind of data with me. You agree? Yes, guys? So we can take this sample data sets that is being provided by Tableau, and you can use this data sets and you can do the report creation. Okay, so let's use this data set. I will click on the sample data sets here. Guys, can you all see my screen? I will click on
yes.
Sample data sets. It will take us to the resources area where this is the sample data that we will work on. It has different categories: entertainment, Netflix, and so on and so forth. And it has the extent dot data set dot XLX and CSV and so on and so forth. So the whatever you want to work on, you can work on, guys. Okay, we have multiple, and if you want any kind of data, education related data, government, science, lifestyle, and so on and so forth. And if you want any other data sources, you can also pull it from here as well. Okay, guys. So right now we'll just go to a very simple data just for us, only for a very simple understanding. We will take a very basic and a very small thing called as this. Do you see this, guys? Cats versus dogs popularity in the US. So basically, I am trying to pull out the cat versus dogs popularity in the US. Okay, I am taking this because it is, you know, XLS, Excel format. So let's click on it. So I will download the file. Okay. This is the file that we have downloaded. Okay, guys. So right now the data here speaks about the locations in the US, Alabama, different states, okay, in the US. And we all have number of households, number of complete households, forget the dog and cat, it's a number of households in the states. And they also have percentage of households only with pets, dogs, cats, any other pets. Then here, number of pet households is a percentage, and this is a number. We have percentage of dog owners, dog owning households, mean number of dogs per household, similarly dog population, and same thing for cats, percentage of cat households, percentage of cat owning houses, mean number of cat households, and cat population. Okay, so this is the data that we have. So according to this, we can create the reports. Clear so far, guys? This is what it is. So now what will I do? I will just save this data on my desktop. Okay, so it's very important for us to actually understand what kind of data we are dealing with, guys. So before you talk about converting this raw data into the reports, please first try to understand what is the data that you're working on, because accordingly it's very easy for you to pull out the reports. Okay, so first understand what is the data. So they have states, they have dogs, and they have cats, and so on and so forth. Okay, chalo, now I have understood my data. Now what I go Tableau public. Now what is the extension? Excel, right? I will click on Microsoft Excel, and I will get the data. Okay, so the data is going to come and fall inside the Tableau. Okay, so guys, if you look at this, this is called as the data source. Okay, now what do you mean by the data source? Whatever data I have pulled from the Excel, it is going to come and sit like this in Tableau. Okay, this is how the data will sit in the Tableau. Clear so far? So whatever fields you have, location, states, and so forth, whatever data that I have pulled up, this is how it will sit in Tableau. Okay, so please understand, this is called as data source. This is called as data source. And now what will I do using this data source? I will create the sheets. Now, guys, please understand, here we have two important pieces that you have to understand. Okay, number one is called as a sheet. Now, what do you mean by a sheet? Sheet is nothing but an individual report that you are creating. Okay, now we have one, is as I mentioned earlier, we have a sheet and we have a dashboard. Okay, now a sheet is wherein you will create probably Excel, or let's assume a table becomes one sheet, your graph becomes one sheet, your pie chart can become one sheet, your representation in the map, state wise representation, can become one sheet. Now what am I doing? I'm trying to collaborate, or in other words, merge, okay, all the different sheets, and then we are creating a dashboard. So please understand, what do you mean by a dashboard? Dashboard is nothing but an interactive combination of your sheets. Okay, so now let's assume I want to understand what is the population of cats and dogs, okay, in a specific, in America, in US. So what kind of information would I need for this, guys, to get this kind of a dashboard? What do I need? What fields would I need? Probably I would need the names of the states. Probably I would need the total number of households. Okay, then I would also need number of households with cats. Then I would also need number of households with dogs. Don't you agree? Probably if I have this data, I would be able to pull out this dashboard. So please understand, the name of the dashboard is this. Okay, now to make sure I get this information, I have to create different sheets, and I'll collaborate all those sheets in this dashboard. Okay, so now what is the advantage of a Tableau? Whatever changes you make in these sheets, everything will be updated in the dashboard. Okay, you don't have to really work on the dashboard again. It is a very interactive dashboard. So what is the advantage of Tableau? Tableau would give us interactive dashboards. Clear so far, girls? All of you guys? Okay, now let's go to sheet 1. So here, when I'm talking about sheet 1,
am I audible?
Not that.
I have a question.
Go ahead.
So Tableau interacts with data. We have to manage. So question is, do we have to manually pull the data in a particular format every time and then plug into Tableau, or does Tableau talk with servers like SQL Server, Oracle Server, or database servers?
Tableau would also will connect with the servers. It will. You can connect Tableau with the servers. But again, what kind of data you want Tableau to convert, you have to manually tell it. Because
That is understandable.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, that is understood. That kind of a data we want is a manual work that we have to do. That's agreeable. I just wanted to know, I had a question, if Tableau talks to the servers like SQL Server and another thing automatically.
It will definitely connect to servers. Yes, it can. It has the ability to do that.
And is there any API, or is there any option in Tableau tool itself that we can, like we plug in the Excel file right now for cats and dogs? Is there any API or option where in Tableau where we can ask that Tableau to connect to a particular server giving the extension?
You can. I'm telling you, right? You can. We have an option here, right? I'll let me.
Okay.
Do you see this here? To a server?
Yep. More. Mm-hmm.
Right, so yes, did I answer your question?
In a office
yeah
sense, I would have this will server names here.
Undoubtedly, yes, yes, okay. Yes. You will have server names and you can connect to the server, yes.
Thanks.
Okay, yeah. Okay, guys. So now what did I do? I actually created the data source and I have want to now create sheets. Okay. So please understand what is this left side. It is nothing but whatever fields and columns that you have in the data source, everything is popping up here. Okay. So now you have to just drag them accordingly and then you'll create the reports. Okay, that is number one. Then what do? We have something called as pages. What all pages you want to talk about, you know, and then we have filters. If you want to create any filters for you to, you want to hide any data, you want to pop out every data, accordingly you can create the filters. And what is this, guys? It is nothing but how do you want that to happen? Do you want any colors or do you want to have different sizes? All that kind of changes can happen here. So let's look at it. And these are your ways you can display your data. Clear so far? You have a text table. You have heat maps. You have tables, highlight tables. You have symbol maps, maps, pie charts, horizontal bars, vertical bars, and so forth. You have multiple other ways to do that. Now, let's see how you can handle this, guys. See, now let's assume I want to drag location. I got the location. Okay. Now, let's assume I want to talk about I want to know total number of households. Okay. Okay, so in the different states, these are the number of households that the total number of households. This is one way. So right now, see one very important thing. When I have created this report, what just happened, you know, in whatever ways we can show this content, it is coming out. Do you see this, the ones I highlighted? So these are the ways you can highlight your content. See, you can either want to do it in a table, or you want to do it more like state wise table, or you want to show it like this, you want to show it like a sheet, however you want to show it. See, however you want to show it, you can. So please understand, Tableau is actually giving us an advantage to make sure it is giving you an option. Now if you want to probably change it like this, you want to make it like a bar, or you want Tableau to decide what it wants to do. Now let's take a color. Okay, how do you want the color to come? So probably I want this color. Probably I want some other color. However, guys, you can just play around. Clear so far, guys, what I'm doing? Okay, so I have created this one sheet. What is this name? What is the sheet I can want to rename? It is your states versus the households. That's done. Now probably I'll create one more sheet here. In the sheet again, I would want to talk about the locations. They will talk about the names. There is no measure that we gave, and we'll talk only about this dog owning houses. Okay, so these are the only dog hold and thing. And again, if you want, again, probably your dog owning, and where is the pet number of pets. Okay, so dog owning households, and maybe and your excuse me. So this is in state wise, it is dog owning households and cat owning households. Again, let's assume I want to change it now. I want to put it like this. So now, you know, I just drag my things here. I will know in Georgia we have 1037 cat owning and 1522 dog owning households. Or probably if you want to put it like this, you can also do it, guys. Again, if you want, you can change the colors, edit the colors. Probably you want. Just I'm just putting it just for our understanding, guys. Okay. I want it like this, or maybe just change the colors, whatever you want. Just put the colors. Are you getting this, guys? So this is nothing but your states that would have cat owning households and dog owning households. Okay. Again, one more sheet I can create here. Wherein again I would say number of households in thousands. Then I'm talking about the percentage, and then I'm talking about the percentage of dog owners, maybe. Then I will create a, so it says that is the only way that you can represent it. Are we getting it, what I'm trying to do here? This is how you will represent your data. You guys, so I have created these different sheets. Any doubts, anyone, the way I'm creating, you can just play around with the data. You can take any other data and again create.
I have a question here. Will WB enable us to get a cumulative graph?
Cumulative graph in the sense?
Like we have a Pareto chart. So in a Pareto, we get the cumulative data, like percentage cumulates gets to 100% at the end.
You can. So that
so basically, that is used for quality purpose.
You can. You will be coming out. The only thing is the way in the data, things are changing. You can. You want it like that. You can. Yes, you can.
I just wanted to know to get the top 20 factors affecting the data.
You can. Trust me, you can. If you want, you can. There's a lot of data sources that are available on Tableau. You just have to click and start. I have taken this one because it is very easy for me to explain the session. But if you have the time, you can take a bigger data and you can definitely play around.
Mm-hmm.
I would suggest, I think I would suggest you should do it because it's a very interesting thing and you can do a lot of things with the Tableau. But I'm just giving you a basic understanding in the session because I don't want to complicate the data. That is the reason why I've taken this very simple data.
Got it.
Yeah? Are you able to understand, guys, all of you? Anyone, any doubts here?
Hello, madam.
Yeah. Yes, please.
Madam, sorry for the interruption. Madam, my internet connection has lost at the starting, so I don't know how to drag the data and put in this Tableau. Like, what we are measuring the data about the graphs and what.
I'm sorry, I can't understand your question. What you can do is probably, if you have any doubts, did you miss the session from the beginning?
Like, no, madam. Starting, I'm understood how these graphs are. You, how are you showing these graphs? But how this data is, how the data is kept in this Tableau?
Here, just very simple. You just have to go here. You have to select a data sample set, data set, and you go and click on Excel.
Yeah.
Okay. You can just copy paste.
Okay.
Yes, then you can, you go here.
Yeah.
Then
Microsoft Excel.
Go to cats and dogs. Okay.
Okay, open.
It automatically get into Tableau.
We can. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, from there. From there, we should select what we are. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. From here, you want to play with the report.
Yeah, from here we are, madam. Yeah. Yes, yes. How are we selecting this?
We are just dragging and dropping into rows and columns.
Okay.
Yeah, so far, guys, any doubts, any questions? The way I've reports, guys, good, right? Now, I would want to create the dashboard. Now, let's talk about a new dashboard. So, now, I have created the sheets. I will create a dashboard now. Okay, number one. Let's go to the dashboard. Here, we have to create the dashboards. Now, what you can do, I have different sheets. Do you see the sheets, guys? You just have to drag and drop the sheets in your dashboard and you can name the dashboard. Here, how do you want the dashboard to look like? See, do you want it to be titled or you want it to be floating? What do you mean by title? Let me do that. See, I will just drag and drop and they are all sitting like tiles. See, I just want to drag it a little. Wait, 1 second. Just want to. So I'm creating the tiles and accordingly you can make it sit in however you want, guys. Again, you want to do anything with it, you can. Or else if you want it to be tiled, what will I do? I'll just have to close all of this. Again, we'll go to the floating. Now what will I do? You can just place it wherever you want. What do you mean by tiled is what is floating is you can just replace everything on top of it, just like floating, you know, everything will come across and you can play with it, guys. Are we clear so far? And then you will rename the dashboard and you will represent it to your person. Okay. So now I would want to take title. Now just put it here. Okay. Now I would want to show the title and then we will. What do you mean by the story is when you want to create the multiple dashboards and like create my more like a story. You want to talk about, let's assume you did a project and you want to talk to your management from day one, you know, and you want to see it. So you can actually create like a story and you can multiple dashboards you can combine and then you can create like a story that can be done. If you want to review on your device, how it would look like. This is how you will it will be displayed on your and how we want to change the size of the image also you can play with it. Are we getting any questions, any doubts? Is anybody any doubts here with how to work on the reports and then create a dashboard? Good. Your task is again just take any Excel file and start working on the database. Okay. Do you have any doubts for me, guys? Anybody?
I have a question.
Go ahead.
Yes, I have a question.
Want to say again,
so in the
please, yeah, use.
Yeah, go on.
Go ahead.
In the input format, like where we plug in the data, there's an option of text file. So, does the data in the text file be organized or
no.
structured or any like any random?
Please don't do that. The advantage of Tableau itself is to convert raw data. We have an option here. See, I'll show you. See here, when you're talking about any kind of data, we have a Tableau interpreter. See, I'll show you the question. You see the data interpreter? whatever is only trying to clean your data.
Okay. So it means if the Excel file does have an image attached or any other links attached, will that be also faced in?
If you really ask me, I would not suggest image because, you know, here Tableau is concentrating more on the data. But if you want the image to be displayed in a dashboard, okay, that can be done by probably dragging into a dashboard. See, you can't convert an image, right?
What I'm asking is if, say, there's an image plugin in the Excel file that I'm trying to import here. So will that image file or link or anything which I have inserted, like say suppose I have one image file, I have one Word file embedded in the Excel file, which is I am importing in Tableau. Will those files also be imported inside automatically or I have to manually drag it?
I don't think so. You can actually import an image file because the image can't be read. If the data in the image is editable, yes. Probably, yes, I can. But again, if it's just like an image, just like a picture that you've taken and you want to do something with it, it might not be able to do that.
Okay.
So the data has to be more like...
So is there an option where in Tableau where I can embed that image or say suppose I have very important instructions, SOP and things referring which I have created the data in case. That's not always the case, but... In case, so am I able to plug in that particular file or location? Say in this report, I have to plug in, say suppose referring this data, I have obtained so-and-so data or charts.
You can give the location, Tableau will drag the data into this tool. Yes, you can.
Okay.
You can.
All right, thanks.
You're most welcome, guys. Yes. Anything else that you want to see? If you look at here, you have extensions, it can drag images, it can pull out whatever you want to be pulled out, can be pulled out into the dashboard and you can create such dashboards. Okay, so far, guys?
Yeah, another question.
Uh-huh.
Sorry, I have a lot of questions. Once we have created the dashboard and we are ready to share with the leadership or the team who will be working on this analysis, is it mandatory for that team to have access to Tableau or can I export this to email or any PDF or something like that? How do I share with them?
Honestly speaking, if you want this data to be interactive, like what I'm telling you, right? If you look at it, put the content on here, you can see this, right? The location, if I'm dragging, hovering my mouse over this data. Right, but if you convert and if you can put it in Excel, it will most stored like an image. You cannot have this interactive dashboards available when you convert it to an image or to a Gmail account. But if you want your management to understand what is this data, to read this data as they are viewing it, it is better you save it in Tableau as a Tableau.
Ma'am, Tableau Reader can be used for accessing the data, like for viewing and, previously you said about Tableau Reader. So can we use it here?
No, we can't use it here because these are all paid versions.
So that is only used for Tableau Public.
Desktop.
No, I'm asking Tableau Reader is only used for Tableau Public.
Tableau Desktop. Tableau Public is what we are using.
Okay. Got it.
Probably to answer your question, sir, probably if you want to read Tableau, if you install Tableau Reader in your computer, yes, you can probably, if you send it as an image into an email, probably people can read it if they have Tableau Reader in their installed. Because Tableau Reader concentrates more on reading the dashboards. These interactive dashboards can be read through Tableau Reader. If you don't have Tableau, just install Tableau Reader to read.
Okay. Oh, I'm asking because if I'm working on a client account and I want to represent the data this pictorial graph, the thing that I have to understand is they should have access to either Tableau or they should be able to read this.
Probably they should have Tableau Reader. That is when they'll see, they can read the report, they can read, but if you look at this image as it is, do you understand anything from this image?
Yes.
I want to hover my mouse on this.
No.
Right. So in order to understand this, and the reason why we have this is, see, if a date change the data in sheets, this data will change. If I change the data in the data, this data will change. So the reason why we would want Tableau is because to have such interactive dashboard, that's the advantage. Or else we could just use an Excel also, right?
So is there an option where I can, like this, here we can see Texas is populating automatically.
Mm.
So is there an option where I can export this data into Pivot? Sorry.
Into?
Into a slide, into PPT slide, right? And name these graphs like this. Name this graph.
You can.
And name this field automatically. And say, suppose, send it to our manager for a quick review. So I can do that, right?
You can. You have one sheet that you want to show it in a dashboard, you can. Just create a new dashboard and just put one.
Okay.
That's it. But the dashboard, the reason why we have dash, it's called as a dashboard, is because we're trying to show multiple different types of data. I wanted to show you this, guys. How this I wanted to show how actually this cats and dogs have been created. I'll tell you what. I just wanted to know how this worksheet would look like. Workbook.
How is this person shared this data?
It is available on public. Some people have done this for the project. Could be public, right? We can view it. Your data can also be viewed if you save it in Tableau public.
Not sinking in. So let's back to our W dashboard we have, and save this book for management with the review.
Do you see it here? When you go open Tableau public, you can view that work.
Okay, all right.
Yes.
Okay. Same kind of thing, our management will have an option and they can access the reports anytime, and that will be live
changing. I'm sorry? Dragging.
Getting it, guys? What I'm telling you? So if you want to save it,
ma'am, how to create?
Yeah, go ahead.
Madam.
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, ma'am, how to create a workbook like the previously you have shown. Okay, the data can be accessed through can be accessible through that Tableau public. People can see it, but how to convert it in a particular workbook? Like previously you have shown.
You have to save it like this.
Oh, okay. So only by saving it will be appearing like that.
Only after saving only you'll be able to view your dashboard. Yes, you have to save your work.
Oh.
So someone had a doubt, sir. Some
kind of, madam, madam, how should we access this data, madam? We can't get this. Here it is showing like sheet.
No, you have to go here and go to the sample data sets.
Madam, once you show the
which picture?
How at initial we start back of data in the from Excel.
Okay. To this tab. Okay, number one, you go to the sample data sets.
Yeah.
You pull data from your resources. I have saved this.
Okay.
Into my desktop.
Okay. I to save.
What do you do?
Do test.
You go to MS like this.
Yeah.
Open.
Yeah.
You come to here. This is the data source that you have that is saved here.
Yeah, save is showing, madam. From here, how
from here go to sheet one.
Show the tables and graphs.
All sheet of one. The sheet one, yeah.
Okay.
All the data is displayed here. Raw data.
Where it is, ma'am? Sheet, ma'am. I can't. I'm where sorry? Is sheet one, ma'am? Sheet.
Right, it is already there. I haven't.
Where the sheet?
Tabs. It's like
okay, it's already there. Sheet one. Here it is not showing, madam. Sheet one.
I don't.
Down, total down. Here.
It should be there, Andy. Because that is a tool.
Yeah, madam. It's showing.
Yeah.
It's showing, madam. Thank you.
It's clear so far now. Is it clear? Tableau? Any other questions for me?
The one who have I mean who have Tableau, they only can able to see our workbooks and everything, right?
Generally, if you're using Tableau and if your organization use Tableau, it will be installed in your project stakeholders computers, because if your project is using Tableau, everybody who's connected to the project must have an access to Tableau. Or else you're only trying to display the data that, see, basically reports, right? You will actually show reports to the management, right? If that is the case, when you have a PPT or a presentation, you can take this Tableau and you can show it there also. You'll take your computer anyways to the meeting rooms, right? You can show it there. But again, undoubtedly, everybody in your project will have access to Tableau for sure.
Okay, the process is same, right? Like we have to save and we
yes
we have to go to file and we have to save that.
Yes, you can do two different saves. See, one is save Tableau public, you can view your work again coming to Tableau login, or else you can save the Tableau public as a as independent sheet in your computer.
Okay. I mean, individual sheet means
like this. You save it, you sign in here, and you save it on your computer.
Okay.
Okay.
But it won't look like worksheet, right?
It would. It would look like worksheet. But again, my advice is to show it in Tableau, because if you can change the data, no? You can still play with the data. Advantage like this changes. See, all this can come.
Okay,
if you want to change the colors of the states, you can have multiple colors and so on. Clear so far?
Each sheet has to be saved individually, or else yes. As a whole workbook, you can save the whole workbook.
You can save the worksheet. You can save the workbook. What I'm saving only.
Okay.
Here I'm saving as workbook. So now I'm working on the sheet.
It will save the entire workbook. Okay. Okay. So it's not like if you want to save only one sheet out of it, can we do that?
You generally don't do that, because if you want to do that, you can just save your work, the whole thing will be saved anyways. But generally, we don't want to save only single worksheet, because it's anyways there here. When you log in into your Tableau again, you'll see your work anyways.
Okay.
But if you want to just see, let's assume you want to only show this one to your management. Don't want all of this to be shown. What do you do? Remove it. Delete it.
Okay.
Okay, you just can delete it. And
what I have saved in public can be accessed on desktop, and what I've saved in desktop can be accessed in public as well, right?
No. Basically, public is only used for practice. When you go to
But when it is, as long as it is available on public, for example, again, I'm going to my office and trying to work on a desktop. So from there, I can pull my data, which I worked on the home in public.
You see, when you
because it's public.
Public, you will not have public if you have desktop. Now, why do you want to have public when you have desktop paid version?
Okay.
Will not even touch public, right? Because you have already purchased Tableau and you can do everything on a desktop. Why do you want to use public? Public is generally not a recommended one when it is your office data, because public can be viewed by everybody.
Okay.
If you want to work at home, you will use your office laptop only to work on desktop, but don't use public for office data.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. Okay, guys. Any other questions for me?
No, from my end.
Done, guys. If you have no other questions, then we will log out, and then we will. Then please, my sincere advice is please practice Tableau. It is not like other tools. You know, you just listen and you're over. Please take the data and start playing with Tableau. That is when you'll get a hands-on understanding of Tableau. Okay, clear, guys?
Yeah. What is the percentage of usage of Tableau in a complete BA profile?
That all depends on the company. If your organization is concentrating on the reporting, okay, then they would use any kind of reporting tool that I mentioned earlier. Okay, but the reason why we're concentrating on Tableau is because Tableau does not need any coding, and you do not need any specific understanding to do the BI, to learn reporting. The reason why is, this is why we have taken Tableau. We cannot say what is a percentage, because it all depends on the organization's decision.
Okay.
Yeah, but yes, big companies do take Tableau. I would not disagree on that part as well. Okay, guys?
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay, guys, thank you so much. Have a great day. Have a great weekend.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Most welcome, guys. Bye-bye.
Hello,